Now we are discussing about the areas of the region bounded by the ellipse equation. The problem, find the area of the region bounded by the ellipse equation x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. First, we can write the ellipse equation. Ellipse equation is x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. Okay. Now, the function, the given curve is converted into y is equal to f of x function. For that, we can leave the second term left side and x square by a square is taking to right side. Y square by b square equal to 1 minus x square by a square and b square. Y square is equal to b square into, taking the LCM of that, a square minus x square by a square. Next, squaring on both, take square root on both sides, positive square root, that is y is equal to b square by a square into a square minus x square, it's under root, okay? Then, what is the y? Y is equal to f of x is equal to b by a, it is a square terms right outside, and under root of a square minus x square, this is the function of x. Next, we can find out the limits. For that, we put x equal to 0, x equal to 0 in ellipse, in x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. X 0 means we're getting a y square by b square equal to 1. Why? Because 0 by something is 0. And cross multiply y square equal to b square. Then the limits equal to y equal to plus or minus under root of b squared equal to plus or minus b. Okay. Next, find out the y limits. Find out the x limits. For that, put y equal to 0 in ellipse. In ellipse equation. Then we get x squared by a squared plus 0 by something is 0 equal to 1, then x square equal to a square. From this, x equal to plus or minus a. Now we can draw with the limits of the curve. Generally, ellipse curve is like this, okay? Okay, here the limits of the x-axis minus a plus a, that is nothing but on the x-axis, the point form is minus a comma 0. On the right side, that is a comma 0. On the y-axis, the limits plus or minus b means it's 0 comma b. This is 0 comma minus b. Observe this. This is the first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. From this figure, the curve is joining to x to y, again x to y, the closed curve. It can be divided into four symmetrical curves, parts, okay? The curve is symmetric in four quadrants. Okay, therefore, area of ellipse is equal to 4 into area of the first quadrant. Area of the first quadrant. Okay, that is equal to 4 into area of the first quadrant means we can take the limits here 0, 0, it is a comma 0, then we are taking the curve with the x-axis. The area of the curve with the x-axis, the limits are 0 to a. We are taking 0 to a into f of x dx. That is equal to 4 integral 0 to a. That y is a function of f of x, that is equal to b by a under root of a square minus x square dx. Now we can use the integral formulas here. B by A is a constant right outside. 4 B by A integral 0 to A under root of A square minus X square dx. It is equal to 4 B by A. Integral of A square minus X square formula is X by 2 under root of A square minus X square plus A square by 2 sine inverse X by A limits from 0 to A. It is equal to 4 B by A. Apply the upper limit. In the place of X write A, A by 2 under root of A square minus A square plus A square by 2 sine inverse A by A minus 0 by 2 under root of A square minus 0 square plus A square by 2 sine inverse 0 by A is 0. It's a lower limit. Here it is 4b by a. This part is 0. 0 into something is 0. Here a by a equal to 1. We know that sine inverse 1 value is pi by 2. So a square by 2 into pi by 2 minus 0 into something is 0. And the sine inverse 0 is 0. The whole part is eliminated. Okay. It's 0. It is equal to 4 b a square pi by 2 to the 4 a cancel, 4 cancel. That is equal to pi a b square units. This is the answer. The next question, find the area enclosed between the curves x square equal to y and the straight line y equal to 3x plus 4. First, write down the given equations. The given equations are, one is x square equal to y is a parabola. Let it be equation 1, and straight line y equal to 3x plus 4. First, how we can draw the y, x square equal to y, okay? We can take x equal to and y equal to. What is this y equal to? X square. We can take x values minus 1, then y values minus 1 whole square is 1. X is 0, y is 0. X equal to 1, y equal to 1. So here we can draw the quadratic axis, that is the horizontal and vertical axis. Here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, like that. Here we can take minus 1, the y-axis is plus 1 only. X is minus 1, y is plus 1. X is 0, y is 0. X is 1, y is 1. So we can draw the curve like this. This is the 1 comma 1. It is the minus 1 comma 1. Okay. Now we can take the straight line. X, Y. X equal to minus 2. What is Y? Y equal to 3 into minus 2, minus 6 plus 4, that is equal to minus 2. Y is also minus 2. X equal to minus 1, y equal to minus 3 plus 4, it is plus 1. X equal to 0, that is y equal to 0 plus 4, it's 4. 0, 4. x equal to 1, y equal to 3 plus 3 into 1, 3 plus 4, it's a 7. X equal to 2, y equal to 3 to the 6 plus 4, it's a 10. 10. Now we can write here. X equal to minus 2, y equal to minus 2. X equal to minus 1, y equal to plus 1. X equal to 0, y equal to 4. X equal to 1, y equal to 7. Y equal to 7, sum here. Five, six, seven, sum 7. X equal to 2, y equal to 10. That is going on here. How it is? Like this, okay? Where it is intersect? X equal to 4. We can take x equal to 3. 3, 3 is a 9. 9 plus 4, it's a 13. X equal to 4. 4, 3 is a 12. Plus 4, it's a 16. Like this, it's going on. Okay. Here, we can take, this is the intersecting point. It is A. Somewhere it is another point. Here, x equal to 4, the y equal to 16. Okay, it's a 16. And we can increase this. Where it intersects, we cannot identify here. Just we can increase this. We can take 2, y equal to 2, 2 is a 4. We can take 3, 3, 3 is a 9. We can take 4, 4, 4 is a 16. So, for x equal to 4, y equal to 16, the intersecting point for the curve, the intersecting point for the curve, it is 4, 0. Here, 4, it is 16. What is that? The line and parabola, both are intersect 4, 16. Okay? See here, it is 4, 16. Here also 4, 16 is there. For that, we can increase the parabola values. Then, the intersecting points are, what is the intersecting points? Intersecting points are minus 1, 1 and 4, 16. So, for with respect to x-axis, the curve, the points are with respect to x-axis means the points on the perpendicular lines from the intersecting point to x-axis, that is minus 1, 0 and 4, 0. These are perpendicular lines. It is the perpendicular lines. Okay. So the perpendicular lines from the intersecting point to x-axis means we are find out the area with respect to x-axis. For that, we can find out the lower limit and upper limit with respect to x-axis. The lower limit is minus 1, upper limit is 4. And the both curves, how we are getting the area? The area is the bounded area with the straight line and the parabola. This is the enclosed area. Enclosed area means this is the upper curve. The straight line is the upper curve. That is Y1. upper curve minus. Why? Because the straight line means that with respect to x means it is the straight line area. It is the straight line area. So this is the upper curve area. Next to minus parabola. Parabola is the lower curve of the enclosed region. Lower curve means we are taking parabola area. This is the parabola area. What is the intersection part? This is the intersection part. So in this, what is the upper curve? Y1 is the upper curve. What is the lower curve? Y2 is the lower curve. Y1 is upper curve means that Y1 becomes the straight line. Y2 becomes the parabola equation. So now we can find out the area, enclosed area between the enclosed area between straight line and parabola equation curves, not equation, parabola curves is A is equal to integral with respect to x-axis. We are taking the x-axis limits are minus 1 to 4 y1 minus y2 into dx. What is the y1 limits? Integral minus 1 to 4 y1 equal to 3x plus 4 straight line equation minus y2 is the parabola equation, that is x square minus x square into dx. Now we write the separate terms and integrate. 3 is a constant right outside, minus 1 to 4 x dx plus 4 right outside, integral minus 1 to 4 1 dx minus integral minus 1 to 4 x square dx. It is equal to 3 into x integration is x square by 2, limits from minus 1 to 4, plus 4 integral of 1 dx is x, limits from minus 1 to 4, minus integral of x square is x cube by 3, limits from minus 1 to 4. It is equal to 3 into 4, 4 is 16 by 2, minus 1 whole square is 1 by 2, plus 4, 4 minus of minus 1 minus 4 cube, that is 4, 4 is 16, 16, 4 is 64 by 3, minus 1 whole cube is minus 1 by 3. It is equal to 3 into 16 minus 1, it is 15 by 2, plus 4 minus into minus plus 1, 4 plus 1, 5, 5, 4 is 20. Minus 3 is the LCM, 64 minus into minus plus 1, it's a 65. Okay, now taking the LCM. LCM is 6. So multiply with 3, 3, 3 is a 9, 15, 9 is a 135 plus into 6, 6, 2 is a 12, 6, 20 is a 120 minus 65. 2 is 130. 130 means 525 by 6 square units. It is the answer.